An Iranian nuclear scientist long suspected of masterminding a secret atomic weapons program has been assassinated near Tehran. Mohsen Fakhrizadeh died of injuries in hospital after armed assassins fired on his car, according to Iranian media. Chief Foreign Correspondent Philip Williams has more.
It happened in a town just outside of Tehran, a small town called Absad City. It looks like there was an explosion and small arms fire, which would indicate that there were people probably on the ground. It's obviously a well-planned attack, and the Iranians have no doubt about who was involved here. They pointed the finger very directly at the Israelis. The Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu a few years ago actually named this scientist by name and said, "Remember this name," meaning that there will, you know, the implication being that there may be news at some point attached to him. Well, some years later, there certainly is. Mm. And from the Iranian point of view, no doubt who did it, but the Israelis are not saying anything. They're maintaining silence at the moment. So we can only really speculate about who did it and why. Mm. But of course, if it was the Israelis that did it, then the implication would be pretty simple. That he was heading the Iranian nuclear effort, and that he had knowledge, he had deep knowledge, and would be the one person that could propel that program from peaceful program to nuclear bomb. And that's what the Israelis have said they will never allow to happen. Well, he was extremely significant, not a household name, of course, but extremely significant. He was well known. He headed that program. He was the leader of the research center in the elite Revolutionary Guard, and he was a leading member of the Iranian nuclear program. So a very important man, a man with deep scientific knowledge. And I think if it was the Israelis involved in that, or whoever it was no doubt that brought his downfall, because clearly they wanted to eliminate somebody with the depth of that knowledge. Mm. There is, of course, other possibilities that other countries or other individuals or groups could have been involved in this. But from the Iranian point of view, all the suspicions point towards Jerusalem. You've got the spectre at the moment, of course, of Joe Biden coming in as the US president, and he has expressed the view that he probably will rejoin in some form or another the nuclear deal that was hammered out between the Americans and the Europeans, ostensibly to control, to stop the spread of a nuclear weapons program in Iran in exchange for lifting of sanctions and various other incentives. That program was abandoned by Donald Trump, but I guess you have to ask the question, particularly as this scientist worked for the Revolutionary Guards, who act pretty independently of government in a sense. They are, in a sense, a law to themselves, as how they will react to doing a deal now with the American new administration. So it may have those sort of implications. It's a bit early to tell if it will. But certainly what it will do is absolutely enrage the Iranian government, who, of course, have had other leaders assassinated in various places around the world. Mm. And, you know, this if this is an Israeli attack, it will, again, just from the Iranian point of view, underline that their absolute visceral hatred of the Israelis, and of course do nothing in terms of encouraging some sort of rapprochement or deal.